Hey Luma, welcome to the stream. How are you doing today? Well, thank you for confirming. But yes, to everybody, happy Wednesday. It is August 30th. We are almost at the end of August. So the end of the month is very, very quickly approaching. You were just playing Gardic Fun with Undies. Well, that must have been fun. That sounds like it would have been a lot of fun. I hope you enjoyed that. Everything is going so fast. Yeah, it really is, honestly. Well, that's good. I'm glad that it was a fun game for you guys. So for today's stream, I know it's been a very long while since I last put out a wallpaper, so we're going to be working on one today. And no worries, Luma will still be here. Welcome back.
Just checking the canvas size here.
Thank you for contributing more points. We got just under 4K. I mean, it was hot again today. I haven't really gone outside because it's been so hot. But it is supposed to start cooling off starting tomorrow, and next week is supposed to be in the 80s, which is very welcome considering it's been over 100 the last couple days. So I will gladly take 80 degree temperatures any day over 100, because quite frankly that's just too warm. It's too hot. The temperatures are at least going to be going down, so we're not just totally melting the entire time. It's 60 degrees. Yeah, that's definitely on the cooler side. Definitely. But I know it's technically winter for you guys, so it's definitely going to be different weather-wise, you know, for you guys versus where I am. So for today's wallpaper, I was thinking of doing one with Niel and 1L. But I haven't fully figured out exactly what I want to do for that. That's true, we could do something like that. To make something on Inkscape, but the program just crashes when you open it. You had to download a portable version for it to work. Dang. Well, that sucks. I hate when apps or anything you're trying to work with just crash for no reason. And it's like, can you just cooperate with me, please? Like, why do you have to make it this difficult? And then Gardic Thumb started, so you didn't do anything. Yeah, isn't that how it always goes? You finally get it to work, but then you have to start doing something else, and it's like, well, okay, I guess. Fortunately, you finished something for Andy since... Oh, it's her birthday today! I'll have to send a message. But happy birthday to them. Little shout out here. I hope that it was a fun one. So I know that is like a art game. What did you guys end up doing for that? Oh, that's awesome. That looks really good, Luma. You did a really good job modeling that. Yeah, that character stylization I actually am familiar with. It's not a game I've ever played. I think it would be a fun game to play, though, honestly. Plus, the character designs are fun. But Jell-O is definitely a more complex shape, so I could see that being more challenging for sure. Yeah, rendering can definitely be difficult depending on the model. And also if the program actually wants to cooperate or not, because that can also make a huge difference. I know for a project that we were working on, one of our final projects when I was in college, we had to build our classroom as a 3D model. So, like, it was the whole class working on this, so everybody was, like, in charge of various objects in the room that we had to model. So, like, the chairs, the tables, the computers, and everything. And then we had to texture and light it and then render it. And I remember at the end, for whatever reason, some of the objects, namely, like, the chairs, and I think the tables, for some reason, the texture on those became very reflective, like a mirror. So it was almost like something got messed up in the rendering process, and we honestly had no idea why it was doing that. Because everything looked perfectly fine up until rendering. So it was kind of a weird thing to happen. But honestly, modeling is just like that sometimes. It's not a whole lot you can do about it. Oh yeah, no, I trust me, I know the difference. We had to fully render it, not just a preview. We had to, like, actually export renders. And yeah, things happened during that process, and we just didn't know what it was, or if whoever was doing the rendering, like, wasn't paying attention and, like, changed settings or something. So, like, to this day, I still don't really know exactly what happened there, but we at least got a good grade on our final project, and that was kind of what I cared about most, to be honest. Yeah. Yeah, it was kind of our teacher was like, I can see that you guys, you know, were trying to be careful on this. It's just something happened with the surface. It rendered really reflective for some reason, like the properties of the texture got changed. But he was like, you know, I get what you guys were going for here, so he was at least, like, really cool about it. He was a good teacher. He was one of the ones that I actually enjoyed his classes. He had a very good sense of humor. Still getting used to Blender though. I am definitely way more used to Autodesk Maya, which was the program that we used when I was in college. So I understand Maya better just because I'm more used to it. But Blender is definitely a good program, so I do want to learn how to use it better. But it's just taking some getting used to regards to, like, how the modeling and everything works. There's a Maya mode configuration for Blender. Does it make the interface more like Maya? Like, is that what that does? Because if so, that might actually help me. Hey Kyra, welcome to the stream. Thank you for the work lurk. I hope that you are having a good work day today. And every day. I hope every day is a good day for you. You think, but you have not confirmed. Well, I'll definitely have to look into that because that might actually help me in the long run, since I am more familiar with the layout of Maya. Oh yeah, so Luma, I found another Pokemon fan game, Pokemon Myth, and you'll be very interested to know that there is a variant of Meloetta in that game, and I saw what it looks like, and it looks fantastic. So you might be interested in that one. I was showing it to Jello and Rose yesterday, but it's a really cool design. they just released a more current version of the game today. So definitely worth taking a look into that, because it's a cool game. They also added evolutions for all the types that have not gotten an official one yet. So I can have my ghost evolution if I so please. But I just sent you a picture of what the Meloetta looks like. It's on the bottom right of that image, but I thought it was a really cool design. So, right? That's what I thought of it. Because, like, sometimes you'll see, like, fake variation designs, and it's like, it's, you know, it's okay, you know. It looks nice, but it's not really my thing. But that one, I was like, oh, that's actually a really nice design for it. So, I definitely had to share that. If you are interested in that, let me know, and I can send you the link for it. I played a little bit of it yesterday, but I am gonna have to start over with the newest version of the game came out, and unfortunately data does not transfer over, so I will have to start over, but that's okay, because I wasn't very far in the first place. But yeah, there's some regional variants, specifically for that fan game, including, like, Pidgey, and there was a really cool fire and dark type Mareep that I absolutely loved. So there's some really, really fun designs in that game. I thought about it, but since I had issues the last time with the stream when I tried, streaming Infinite Fusion, I am a little hesitant to try, because I'm not sure if it's actually going to stream or not. Because, like, trust me, I would love to stream it, but just a little concerned. I don't think it's the game that's the issue, because before I started streaming, it was working just fine, but when I started the stream, it wasn't working. Or the game itself was working, but OBS was not working well with it. And then there was connection issues, despite Jello helping me to try and fix some things. Thank you. mean, I guess we could try it next stream and see if it works. But if not, probably just switch back over to an art stream. Mostly just because I'm not sure how OBS is going to handle. But I've streamed that game before. I had streamed Infinite Fusion before, so I don't know why it was giving such problems last time I attempted. Hello, Rose. Welcome to the stream. Working on a wallpaper because I haven't done one in a while. Listening in from your bed in your Kirby jammies. Sounds nice and comfy. So if you disappear, I know why. It's going okay. Mostly just kind of chill. Very grateful that I can make custom brushes right now, because definitely helps. Thank you. Because that would be too convenient, and that's not allowed. It's like whenever I want to like update the fic that I'm writing, and it's like, okay, I want to write something, like I actually have the motivation to write, and then I try and I cannot for the life of me get anything decent down. It's very frustrating. Or like how, you know, I was telling you what happened with the commission I was working on for you, where it was like, I have all these references pulled up so it looks good. Why is this sketch coming out like absolute crap? And then it's like, okay, you know what? Screw it. I'm gonna forego the references and I'm just gonna doodle and see what happens. And then finally I get a good sketch. And it's like, why? Why does it have to be like this? Yeah, I totally get that feel, Luma. You either have the motivation but don't know what to do, or you know what you want to do but you have no motivation. It's a curse. Yeah, that is exactly it. I am excited for tomorrow, though. know what I'm talking about, then you are a cool person. Well, yes, that is definitely always a plus. But I am excited because tomorrow is the debut of the, yes, Rose, you are correct. That is what I am very excited for. I know, it's not like I've been rambling about it nonstop lately, or One Piece in general. No, actually, Luma, so, there's already been reviews about it, and I haven't seen anything negative. The cast that they chose are all fans of the series, and honestly, I don't think they could have picked anyone better to play these characters. And the creator of One Piece, Oda, has had heavy involvement with this series and was very strict about no compromises because he wanted it just so. And while there are limitations for live action versus like full animation, from what I've seen, it looks like they did a really good job despite those limitations. So this is probably like the only one that I have ever been looking forward to, because it actually seems like there was a lot of care put into it. So I am very optimistic. I think it's going to be fantastic. I am very much looking forward to seeing everything that was done. I think it's going to be good. And I apologize ahead of time to those of you who hear from me often, because that is going to be the only thing that I'm talking about with you guys for the next unknown amount of time. Apologies ahead of time. You were warned. What's this neat little sword next to my name? It means you're a mod. You are a mod. You can kill, yeah, exactly. You're gonna kill any bots or rude people in my streams, which luckily hasn't really been an issue. I think a bot only showed up like once that we had to get rid of, and I think it was actually Luma who got rid of it. But you do have the power, Amy Rose. I keep getting confused by your username. You'll take anything. mean, I hadn't planned on it, and it's not really a name that I have associated with you, so... You're like, as long as you're not misgendering me, I don't really care at this point. Yeah, I know exactly what you mean, trust me. We're gonna make another brush. Okay, that's valid. Star. Star indeed. At least my attempt at one. I don't think that'll be an issue. That's pretty fantastic. Oh my gosh, that's funny. Hello, welcome Raiders. I hope y'all are having a good week so far. Hello Undies. Luma was telling me that it was your birthday and that y'all were playing Guarded Phone. I hope that was super fun and that you're having a fantastic birthday. Them ads. So for today's stream, I am doing a wallpaper that will be freely available to anybody in my Discord group. So yeah, that will be available for y'all to download if you so desire. Mostly just kind of hanging out. How was your stream? Well, that's good. I'm glad that it was a good stream and that you had fun. That's definitely what matters most. Have a good rest, friend. And have a wonderful rest of your birthday. That's not the right color. Ew, gotcha. Yeah, that's not an easy thing to do. I don't think I would be able to do that myself, honestly. But props to Undies for trying. You think you could if you had a big enough amount of viewers? I mean, that's fair. I don't think that I would be able to keep my energy for that long. even with a ton of caffeine, I don't know if I would be able to do that. You have the energy if you have enough social interaction. That's totally fair. It was definitely easier to, like, keep going for sure. Luma lives with 5% energy. That is a whole mood right there. You're a vibe sponge. High five to all the chronic low energy people in here. Vibe sponge is funny to say, but also 100% true. If someone just has horrible vibes, I immediately feel it and feel a good vibe to get watched. Yeah, you know, I honestly can't say I'm very different from that. Yeah, that sounds about right for you. Just, yes, I know that you are having a bad day or something because your vibes are way off. Something is going on here. Let my hugs restore the positive vibes, so long as they are willing to accept said hugs. no, I'm not. I'm not trying to insinuate that you just like randomly hug people.
Thank you.
you're trying to convince Andy. Oh, who's up at the... I don't get to comment because you were scolding me about that last night, so... I don't get to say anything. Whatever. What are you gonna do about it, Rose? But then you'd be canceling your commission, so you'd be losing out too. That's why I take my favorite little melatonin and Benadryl combo. And then I don't have that problem. Melatonin and Benadryl are my friends. Yeah, if that is something you can get a hold of, I highly recommend it because melatonin is something that your body naturally produces. Sometimes your body just doesn't produce enough. So I take 15 milligrams of melatonin, and it helps me with falling asleep and staying asleep. So that's not always accurate because sometimes I just forget to change my status from online to offline. So it's not always accurate. Melatonin. That is oddly fitting. New Meloetta form unlocked. It only sings lullabies. Now that would be a Meloetta I would want to have as a friend. It's okay, Rose. I knew what you meant. Autocorrect is a very things sometimes. It's very good at sabotaging your messages. I've had it send some very, not great things in the past, which always then leads to a panic of, I was not trying to say that! Autocorrect is doing some horrible things today. Yeah, that's a mood. That you have messed with my messages for the last time. But no more. Give them the Tinkerton treatment. That's, yeah. I hate when it does that, and it's like, no, I purposely spelled it this way, can you please just not change it? And then autocorrect is like, I'm still gonna change it. It's like, why are you like this? sometimes I like to throw patterns on these just so it doesn't seem so flat. Did it again. And now it's time for shading! Quick, I'm gonna save. Been having so many spam bots following me lately on Tumblr, it's very annoying. It's like I block one and then I get like five more, and it's like, staff, you really need to, like, get on this, because it tends to happen more if you're active. If you aren't really doing much on your account, then you won't really see them as much. But like if you're posting a lot or reblogging a lot, that's when they tend to go after you more, it seems like. So it's... it's legitimately very annoying. Mm-hmm. And it's weird because, like, there's these weird intervals where I'll get, like, nothing, and then all of a sudden I get slammed with, like, a ton of these bot accounts, and it's very frustrating, because I'm just like, these need to, like, go away permanently. I am so done with them. One Luma. I honestly don't know if there's anywhere else. Like, I have an Instagram account, but I do not post anything on there. I don't really understand Instagram very well, which is why I have not posted much of anything on there. I think I have maybe like 2 or 3 posts. And that's it. I don't really get it. Yeah. I have a lot of friends who use it, and I've had people tell me, oh, you need to post your art on there. But, like, I don't know. I don't really care for it as a social media platform. So it's just like, if Tumblr ever, like, went down, I legitimately don't know where I would go. Because I refuse to go to Twitter. I have never had a Twitter account. I refuse to have one because I hate Twitter. So it's like, really, I don't even really know anything else. I used to have a DeviantArt account, but they started doing things that I didn't like. So I ended up deleting my account. After saving images, of course. But it's just like, I don't know where to go anymore. There really isn't a large selection of, like, platforming choices that you get. Yeah, I just refuse to go anywhere near Twitter. Especially considering who currently owns it. That should never have been able to get his grubby little hands on it in the first place. Yeah, that's another thing that I've heard about that, and just another reason why I refuse. Thank you. I tried ArtStation? I have not. I did have one friend recommend it to me, but I haven't really looked at it. And I haven't really seen any other artists that I follow talk about it, so I haven't really thought about trying it just because I don't know anything about it. I don't know if it's like actually any good or not. Yeah, then that's a definitely no-go. Yeah, if I have to pay for it, absolutely not. Guess who fell asleep? Definitely not the person who just sent the message, right? Wink, wonk. If you do end up needing to leave, though, don't worry about it. Considering you've got a busy job and all, there is no shame in that. Well, sleep well. I make no promises about doing, going to bed at a, you know, decent time, so no harping on me later. This will be available on the Discord later, once it's finished, so everybody will have access to it. Thank you. find it weird that the selection highlights are reversed. What does that mean? No worries. I was just curious what you meant. So we got the base shadows, but now I'm going to add some stronger ones. Thank you kindly. Adding these darker shadows just makes things pop a little more. Thank you. usually have the brush opacity for, at least for this brush, on. Usually try not to go higher than 10%. Just helps blend the colors a little easier. Yeah, just cause like, so if you have it on full opacity, it's just straight up dark. Which in some cases it works, but like in this case, if I have it on only 10, you can see I can make it darker in some areas and lighter in other, because you're able to layer it when it's only at 10%. So you can have it soft, but then as you keep going over it, it gets darker. So that just, it makes things easier to blend. Which in turn makes the shading or coloring, whatever you're using this for, it makes it smoother instead of just like a very sudden change to the shading. The size of the brush also has an effect on this. If the brush is very tiny, even if you have the opacity low, it does not work very well. It still comes out as if you had the opacity at like 100% because the brush is just so small and compacted that it doesn't really give it a chance to blend. Do the shading with some kind of like purple, like blue violet, pure purple. It varies, and then I'll take a look at how that color looks with the actual colors visible, because sometimes it doesn't quite work, so maybe it's like, oh, you know, I shaded this with purple, but, you know, maybe I should have done this with, like, green instead. You can just go and adjust the hue, and then it's all fixed. So, luckily, changing the colors of the shadows is something easy to do, if you needed to, anyways. Sometimes you don't have to if it looks okay, but sometimes the color just looks wonky, because maybe you have a complementary color underneath, so it just doesn't look very good. Or maybe you're going for a more monochromatic piece, it just kind of varies. So now I can go, maybe this color is too dark, and I can lower the opacity a little bit, or I can play around with the hue and see. I actually kind of like that. So like this one, I moved the hue over a bit. I think it's still in the blue-purple range. Actually, I think it's a blue. Yeah, I moved it over to blue. Which I think works a little better for some of the shadows. So now that I got my shadows down, I can go into the highlights, which I usually do with white on overlay, and then I'll just lower the opacity if it's too bright. Sometimes you just need like a subtle highlight versus a really sharp one. Because a softer highlight can look good, and then like a sharp one might make it feel like it's gel or metal or something that isn't really a material you were going for, which can make things look not as good as you wanted it to. You don't have to put highlights on everything. Because it ultimately depends on how light bounces off of whatever you are drawing. I don't really like I don't really like the color of the background, because it doesn't really fit. So I'm going to put just on the slider. And I like that better. Do want to add a little something to it though. Thank you. It shows three people, but having a what on the list? Yeah, sometimes it isn't very accurate. Why is that material not showing up on the list, even though I have it on my mobile version? There they are. Let's see. Can't see it, but I am adding some materials here. They added some new stuff recently, so I am happy about that. Let's see. Not quite what I wanted. catching us at the end here. I wanted to add a little something over, but I don't really like how that looks. Because it's not really adding what I want. So maybe I'll try a brush instead. The nice thing about having a lot of brushes is, like, you have a lot of options. On the other side, you have a lot of brushes. So how's your day been going, Melly? Okay, that's more like what I wanted. There we go. Okay. Final wallpaper. Slow at work, chilling on the couch with husband while Pirates of the Caribbean plays. Well, you know, that at least sounds peaceful. Alright, so just doing that final save and export. Thank you. happy that the wallpaper came out good. It's been a while since I last posted one. So, that is saved and exported, so I will be sharing that to the group. I ended up finishing that faster than I thought I would. So I guess stream will be ending a little early today. But yes, this will be going up in just a few minutes. But thank y'all for joining in. And I will see y'all on Saturday, where I think I'm going to attempt to stream a game and see if it actually lets me this time, since we had issues the last time I tried streaming a game. But yeah, until next time, y'all take care and have a wonderful rest of your night and a good rest of your week. See you then.